Terminator 2 is a possible candidate for the best sequel of all time and best film in the action sci-fi genre. Any way you look at it, it's a masterpiece. Naturally, video games feeding off its success started popping up all over the place. The one most people were familiar with was the arcade shoot-em-up by Midway. It's ported to the Sega Genesis and Super Nintendo. The gameplay is just as mindless as ever. Move the cursor around the screen and shoot everything in sight, except for your comrades who just get in your damn way. You know, I wasn't aware they made Terminators in gold. Fighting the boss is the most redundant thing of all. It takes more bullets than anything you'll ever see. All you do is shoot, shoot, shoot. In the Genesis version, it looks like Rob the Robot. Otherwise, it's basically the same game, but with slight changes. Some of the sound effects are better. In the Super NES version, when the soldiers get hit, they yell no. Which is stupid. But in the Genesis version, they just scream. Big improvement. But some of the animation's lacking. Look at the barrels. The flames don't even move. Unlike the Super NES version, you get items on the first stage. They come in what looks like a little fridge, and it seems they never run out. How many items could there possibly be in this one little box? The worst part is where you have to protect John Connor. All that happens, he gets killed, and you lose. It's a senseless game, but it was a novelty at the time. The home consoles tried to take advantage of it, with the Super Scope and the Sega Menacer. But the only real way to play it was in the arcade. It was even ported on Game Boy. Now that is pathetic. Now for Terminator 2 on NES. It's all about that little rainbow of death. I swear, I don't even plan this. It just so happens that LJN holds a monopoly on shitty games. They were also behind every home console version of Terminator 2, even the arcade ports. LJN proudly presents. Oh, I bet. Now this, of course, begins an alternate series of Terminator 2 games that differ from the arcade version. Level 1, you're the Terminator going around in a truck stop punching people. It's just a monotonous button masher, and it takes so many punches to put him down. All you want to do is run past him. But you can't do that, because guess what? The whole objective of the stage is to punch everybody out. The sound effects suck ass. It's just boom, boom, boom. There's no difference to when you're punching the air and when you're hitting someone. Couldn't there be at least two distinct sound effects? God, this takes forever. When you're in between them, you keep getting hit. But even if you keep them all on the side, they all bunch together, and still you take a lot of hits. It's the first part of the game, and already I'm fucking sick of it. Then you go in the tavern, like the first scene in the movie. Once again, you gotta punch everybody out. They keep coming out from under the bar. How many guys are back there? Then you come to the boss. Now, who is this guy? He's taller than you, and aren't you supposed to be the Terminator? Arnold fucking Schwarzenegger? It does tend to underestimate the hugeness, doesn't it? Look, I'm dead. He just took out a Terminator, a machine, with his bare fists. This is absurd. If I crouch down, he can't hit me, so I can just punch him all I want. But it goes on forever. In fact, I don't think this hurts him. So why have the character in the game act like he's getting hurt when he's clearly not? Looks like I'm jerking him off. Can be killed, but it just takes a little patience. Level 2, this is the only stage where you're on a motorcycle. One thing you need to know, you gotta shoot the gate to open it, otherwise you just crash. Even after the fact, you can still hit the wall, unless you're perfect. It reminds me of Bart versus the World when you're on the Great Wall of China. Hate that shit. But the most annoying thing is the truck. It keeps coming up from the bottom of the screen and it sucks you toward it. Like, where does it have a magnet on the front? The first time I played this, I had no idea what you're supposed to do. I figured you'd have to accelerate, but couldn't find any way to do so. Turns out, you can shoot back, so all you gotta do is shoot the truck, and then it, like, bounces you forward again. But trying to shoot the truck and pay attention to all the other stuff at the same time is really frustrating. Then you rescue John Connor, and he makes you swear not to kill anyone. So here comes level 3, you're going around the hospital trying to rescue Sarah. You're not allowed to shoot anyone unless it's in the legs, which is simple, but it makes you feel foolish having to duck all the time. I mean, this is the first side-scrolling stage where you have a gun, and you can't kill anyone. Level 4, you're in Cyberdyne on a mission to blow the place up. You go around collecting bombs, which look like, I don't know, a headless chicken holding a dead rat? What, you don't see it? No, I don't know. You take all the bombs and deposit them into this thingamafucker, and you think that's it, right? No, you take the bombs back out and lay them in designated spots. Okay, well, what was the point? Why couldn't you just collect the bombs and put them where they go? I can only imagine what they were thinking. Duh, you put these bombs in this thing? Alright, what next? How about you take them back out and you put them somewhere else? It's treating us like a fucking dog. Go get the ball, bring it back, go get it again. Fucking dickwads. Level 5 is a nightmare. Everywhere you go, you gotta jump on moving platforms. Your accuracy better be perfect or else you're dead. Fuck. It's next to impossible. It teases you by thinking the chain's gonna go lower, but it doesn't. It's as wide of a jump as possible, and the platform doesn't even stay down long enough. You only get 1 microsecond to hit your mark, and there's a fucking fireball. So this jump is one of the most grueling things you could ever accomplish in your life. There's another jump that seems to have a glitch or something. Like, come on, that killed me? I landed on the pipe, not the lava. Well then, if landing on the pipe kills me, why can't it just look the same as the lava? And what about this right here? That's not a platform? Well then why the fuck does it look like a platform? There's some serious issues here. At last, you fight the T-1000 with your fists. Unless you still have some ammo left over from Cyberdyne. That's because there's no ammo on the stage. Not at all. So if you're down to your bare hands, then that's all you're gonna get. If anything, they should have a whole stockpile of ammo to get you ready. Because it's the final battle. If you look at a game, say, from the Castlevania series, right before you get to Dracula, there's a spot where you can load up your supply of items. It's secretive, yeah, but it's there. Even the main corridor has some weapons. But here, you don't get a damn thing. Once you push the T-1000 in the lava, you won. Then you see the final cutscene. It seems they hit all the key scenes in the movie, which is nice, but why they left out the Terminator theme still perplexes me. Next we have Terminator 2 on Game Boy. For a portable console, there's not much to complain about as far as graphics go. In fact, it's pretty well done. You play as John Connor in the future, fighting your way to Skynet. The first stage seems simple enough until you reach the laser barrier at the end. So naturally, you walk back to the left trying to figure out what to do. Then you find out you can shoot these towers. So I take them all down, and still, we have a barrier. Turns out, you gotta shoot the towers in order, from tallest to shortest. What a load of random bullshit. The second level, you're in Skynet. It's more self-explanatory, but these bombs on the floor are such a pain in the ass. I can't shoot them, and I can't jump over them either. Oh, and guess what? You know how most of these games you have 3 lives and no continues? Well, here, you get only one. That's it. You die once, and the game's over. The thought of making it through the entire game without dying once is ludicrous. At the end of the second stage, you have to reprogram the Terminator. Okay, is this how John Connor did it? I never thought this part of the story would make it into the game. Basically, you have to mend the wires together so the electric currents go the right way. But you have a time limit, and it always seems to end right when you start to figure out what you're doing. You can't even pause the game to look at it because the screen goes blank. At least you get a second chance here, but 2 fuck-ups, and you're done. One last game, thanks fucking god. Terminator 2 on Super Nintendo. And does it have the Terminator theme? No, of course not. Well, it's sort of a crappy remix version. How the hell did they make so many Terminator games and not have the theme? The only one I've seen that has it is the Sega CD version. If you watch the demo, it shows a naked Arnold walking into the bar, and they censor him Austin Powers style. Now that's funny. Once you hit start, it bypasses this whole scene. Right away, you have your clothes on and you're going around punching people. All I can say is, my god, the control is so bad. It's so stiff and you can't punch anyone when they're too close. But check out the jump. What is that good for? It's like he's a marionette or he's being hanged by an invisible rope. Like, holy lord, that is some fuck right there. Look at him go, woo, woo, woo! I can't see the reasoning behind it. You can't make something that funny by accident. They took somebody as badass as the Terminator and made him into a mockery. It's a fucking joke. And I'm not just doing this to be funny. It's because of how slow he walks. The only way to go any faster is to hop around like a fucking idiot. Unlike the NES version, the goal isn't to knock everybody out, because they're never ending. In fact, that could be a good joke to play on someone. Like, hey, give it a try, kill all the guys, I dare you. They'll be playing forever. The goal is to find a pistol and a shotgun. But that's not all, you need to find John Connor's phone number. But that's still not enough, you need to collect future objects. I don't know what the hell these are supposed to be, but they look like little coolers or first aid kits. I don't remember them from the movie, so why is it so necessary to include them in the game? Now, unless you played the game before, you probably assume that once you uncover these objects, you collected them. But no, you're supposed to aim your gun and shoot them. Now look at your itinerary. It says collect future objects. So unless your idea of collecting objects is to blow the everlasting fuck out of them, should it say destroy future objects? One thing I find amusing is that everything in this bar blows up for no apparent reason. And you can even attack the waitress. Any sane human being would shut off the game before even completing the first stage. But I tried my best to persevere, and what I found next was this. That little motorcycle, believe it or not, that's you. You can't tell it apart from the others. The first time I got to the stage, I died before I even had a chance to figure out what was going on. Oh yeah, and by the way, one life. Yep, die once, and it's all over. They really stuck to that format, didn't they? Play the whole game in one go. It's unthinkable. Oh man, a head-on collision with a truck and a motorcycle, and the truck explodes. Now let me tell you, I still don't understand how to control this. The main problem being that I can't figure out how to turn. It has something to do with holding the D-pad and the Y button, but I can't get the feel for it. Without even hesitating, I can honestly say, this is the absolute worst driving stage I have ever played. Roger Rabbit was bad, Dick Tracy was horrible, and at the time, I thought that one was the worst. But now that I've played this, just wow.